In this experiment, we talk about the coating methodology in order to prepare structure system. And in particular, we talk about deep coating. With this method, the geometrical support is immersed in a suspension of the material used as washcoat and extracted with constant velocity. An accurate and uniform coating thickness depends on precise speed control and minimal vibration of the substrate and fluid surface. The coating thickness is mainly defined by the withdrawal speed, the solid content in the slurry, and the viscosity of the slurry itself. When the deep coating is applied to monolith's geometrical support, the excess of slurry should be removed. The slurry present in the channel of the monolith could be removed by centrifugation or air blowing or spin coating. To prepare the slurry, we wait and mix water, glycerol, and polyvinyl alcohol. Do you know what are the role of these components? These components are in a specific ratio to each other and to the catalytic powder. Could you calculate these ratios? Now mix the liquid component to obtain a homogeneous solution. Mix the liquid component to obtain a homogeneous solution. In the plastic bottle, add some zirconia balls that are the grinding body used in the ball milling. After that, weigh the catalytic powder. And add it to the solution. In order to obtain a stable and homogeneous slurry, a mechanical and chemical attack are performed using the ball milling. For this purpose, the plastic bottle is put into a jar and then a constant rotation is applied on the ball milling. The ball milling time is normally 24 hours. After this time, the slurry is racked into a becker. A metallic foam represents our support. We immerse the foam into the slurry until all the support is covered by the slurry itself. The extraction of the foam is made vertically and with attention. Due to the viscosity of the slurry, A wet film of slurry coats the wall of the foam, but the main part remains and blocks the channels. So the excess of solution is removed from the foam using a spin coater. The instrument uses a program of rotation speed and a dwell to the maximum velocity. Finally, the sample is dry with a flash drying at 320 degrees C for 5 minutes in order to obtain the final coating. In some cases, a calcination step is necessary to obtain the final sample.